This is Channel 13 News at 10.
This looks a lot like Iowa. Long lines and record crowds for the Nevada caucuses. Tonight, the state is picking its Republican nominee for president. Good evening, I'm Erin Kiernan.
I'm Dan Winters. Thank you for being with us tonight. The results are being tallied right now.
And if the polls are accurate, it should be Donald Trump's third win in a row. This is where he will take the podium later this evening, win or lose. The most recent poll had Trump up by 26 points in Nevada. We'll bring you the results as they come in.
Iowans are still chanting Donald Trump's name weeks after our state's caucus, but not in the way you might think. Channel 13's Justin Cerency joins us now, and this is a bit of a head scratcher, Justin, because high school basketball fans are trying to get into the opponent's heads using a politician.
That's right, Dan. We've all taken pride also when crowds chant USA in fan-filled arenas, but for the Perry High School basketball team, it's turned into a mockery as opposing fans have used the chant to blatantly target the minorities whose parents may be from other countries.
Perry High School bucks the trend of what is typically found in a rural Iowa setting.
We are really more of an urban school, kind of in a rural setting. You know, here at the high school, we're 48% minority.
They embrace that diversity, and it shows on the basketball court with players of Latino, Native American, and African American heritage.
It's all about just who you are as a person, and that's what's great about a small town like Perry.
Unfortunately, that diversity isn't being celebrated by everyone.
We're all aware of racism. It's alive and well in small portions, but it's alive and well.
At Monday night's game against Dallas center Grimes, opposing fans used Donald Trump's disdain for illegal immigrants to target several players of Latino descent.
Things like Trump trying to intimidate us with the things that Mr. Trump has said that he's going to do with immigrants.
With the political climate the way that it is, it's a little more charged.
It's cut the community and players like senior Shamond Ivory deep.
Honestly, disrespectful. That's how I take it. During the game, I hear it all on and off the court, everywhere I go.
It's been a constant almost all season.
We had an Instagram issue about 2 weeks ago with a conference school, and I will say the administrators took care of it very well.
The Blue Jays have found a way to take the high road.
We're respectful, we're loud. And obviously we win. It works. We don't need to be disrespectful.
They've turned hateful chants into motivation.
As soon as I hear something like that, it just triggers me. And it makes me strive more and just to make sure to do it for my team, do it for my coaches, and do it for the community.
A checklist of sportsmanship traits quickly greets everyone who walks into Perry High School's gymnasium. They hope other schools can follow suit, and if not, they hope their play on the basketball court can change the hearts and minds of those affected by their race.
It's not about the color. We're all equal.
Steve Watson, the Dallas Center Grimes Activities Director, confirmed the chants at last night's game and said that the issue has been addressed at the school. He declined to comment on whether any of the students had been disciplined at this time. Also, last year, Perry coach Ned Menke, was awarded the Iowa High Schools Association's Character Counts Coach of the Year.
Very fitting. Wow. Okay, so you've got to imagine a couple of things here, Justin, that this is going to gain them some new fans based on their character, but also that this is hopefully small pockets of fans from these schools that are given a bad name for the rest.
Yeah, they haven't said how many, but yeah. They have heard it several times throughout the season. This is the playoffs now, and it continues to happen, so they're hoping to put a stop.
They've got a game coming up.
That's right. On Thursday in Johnston, they play another game.
Thank you, Justin.
Mm-hmm. We were definitely in the wrong, our student body.
And they aren't making up for it with just an apology. See how Dallas Center Grimes is replacing an insult with a show of support.
Donald Trump found little support tonight. When you're in front, everybody's after you. Here are the attacks in the lead up to the biggest day of the presidential nominating battle.
And empty promises from the federal government. We'll tell you how much it offered to pay to protect Cedar Rapids from this and how much was actually delivered.
From WHO HD, the local news leader. This is Channel 13 News at 10.
They last won a boys' state title in 1988, but for many in Perry, tonight's sub-state game against Boone may have even more significance. Good evening, I'm Erin Kiernan.
I'm Dan Winters. Thank you for joining us tonight. On Monday, we shared how the Perry players faced racially charged chants from a handful of Dallas Center Grimes fans.
Tonight, the fans from the two schools cheered together as one. Channel 13's Justin Cerency has the story.
There's no denying the Donald Trump chants heard from a group within Dallas Center Grimes' cheering section to target the multicultural Perry basketball team and student body had a rippling effect.
Something like that you never really get over. It's something that's been that sticks with you for life.
But instead of making excuses,
we were definitely in the wrong, our student body.
Students from DCG met with Perry students early Thursday and used the evening's Boone versus Perry boys sub-state game to make amends and teach their fellow classmates a lesson in return.
Just like educate them more because we don't have a diverse school very much at all.
I think 48% I saw numbers, so I think it's just understanding their side.
And Perry learned from DCG.
The few that did those chants and said those things were not a full representation of that school.
At a neutral site in Johnston, Perry also welcomed students from Ankeny, Des Moines, Lincoln, Johnston, and Greene County.
It just shows how united we can be, not just with like our own school, but also with other schools, and shows our diversity, and just we're just here to have fun.
Students say it was a select few in the stands Monday that tarnished the Mustangs' name 3 days ago. But now a different group of DCG teenagers with courage and honor put that burden on their backs to show Perry the respect they deserve.
I'm hoping that other schools can kind of take from this and realize that like what they're saying in basketball games is actually affecting the players and the communities and such.
Proving that no matter the circumstance, through acceptance, not exclusion, these two schools understand what can truly make America great again.
How everyone is accepted, everyone is united. It doesn't matter your race, your color, anything. You're just going to be accepted.
And the Dallas Center Grimes students in attendance said that their student government group has already brainstormed the idea of a mutual program with Perry High School that could help introduce their students to more diversity.
Okay, nice. Getting creative.
Yes.
Thanks for the follow-up.
Mm-hmm.